So another one, aryl halides. Aryl halides. So first of all, aryl halides. First we will discuss the preparation methods of aryl halides. That means here chlorobenzene, bromobenzene, iodobenzene. In first year chemistry, you discuss the halogenation of benzene. By the halogenation of benzene, we will get the aryl halides. By halogenation of benzene, we will get the aryl halides. So that means here, the first preparation method, aromatic electrophilic substitution reactions. Aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction. First of all, your benzene. So Cl2 in the presence of AlCl. So H plus replaced by the Cl plus alcohol. And side product is HCl. Now FeBr2. So Br plus HBr. So in this case, here first of all, bromine and iron combination will get the FeBr. And this one on further reaction with bromine that produce FeBr4 minus plus Br plus. H plus replaced by the Br plus. In this case, Cl2AlCl3 combination that gives AlCl4 minus and Cl plus. That is electrophile. So H plus electrophile replaced by the Cl plus electrophile. Okay, it is an aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction. Iron is to choose or directly. AlCl is this one. Any reasons? First, suppose here iodine and AlCl3. Product is iodobenzene. Actually, product is iodobenzene. And side product is HI. This HI is strong reducing agent. This HI is strong reducing agent. Okay. Now, here actually, this hydrogenation is a reversible reaction. Okay, HA is a strong reducing agent. So that reducing agent reduces iodobenzene to HI. Okay? So here in this case it is a reversible reaction. Iodination of benzene is a reversible reaction. So that's why here that iodination must be carried out in the presence of oxidizing agents like HMO3 or HGO or H2O2 like this. Okay, in the presence of oxidizing agent, this reaction must be carried out. So, in the presence of oxidizing agent, this hydrogenation is not reversible reaction because here HI is formed and this HI is consumed by the oxidizing agent. Okay, here in this case, here we are using along with I2 oxidizing agents. So, these oxidizing agents consume the HI. HI is a strong reducing agent. So that reducing agent is consumed by the HMO3 or H2O or H2O2 or O3, whatever it is. So in this case here, that gives NO2 plus I2 plus H2O. I2 plus H2O. So in this case, this one, HI converted to I2. Then rate of, then concentration of I2 increases, then rate of forward reaction increases. HA is consumed by the oxidizing agent, whatever you are using this in this reaction. Okay, that is an hydrogenation reaction. Hydrogenation must be carried out in the presence of oxidizing agents. And here, another method also there. For example, here, this one I am treating with HOCl in the presence of acid medium. H plus increased by Cl plus. Here, because this HOCl in acid medium, HOCl acid medium, this OH protonation takes place. By the protonation of OH, your water molecule is leaving out. Water molecule is leaving out. So you will get the Cl plus is the alcohol. You will get the Cl plus alcohol. So that H plus replaced by the Cl plus alcohol. Now, by using BrCl, Br plus Cl minus, Br plus Cl minus, that means here H plus is replaced by the Br plus and H plus Cl minus combination HCl. Or by using ICl along with ZnCl2. This ZnCl2 is a Lewis acid. So here, and H plus is replaced by I plus. Here I plus is Cl minus. So side product is a HCl. In this case, it is not a reversible reaction because HCl is a weak reducing agent. But H is a strong reducing agent. That's why this iodination is a reversible reaction. But here ICl, for suppose we are using ICl, ZnCl2. So here in this case, I plus ZnCl3 minus is formed. The ZnCl3 acting as a Lewis acid. So that produces a I plus alcohol 5. That produces I plus alcohol 5. So H plus replaces by the I plus and side product the HCl. HCl is a weak reducing agent. So it is not a reversible reaction. It is an irreversible reaction. Iodobenzene successfully formed in this reaction. Okay? Now here, benzene plus F2AlCl. F4O benzene is the product. But here, this reaction is a highly explosive reaction. This reaction is a highly explosive reaction. Because here, F2 is a highly reactive. F2 is highly reactive. So here, direct chlorination, that means here, preparation of the fluorobenzene by using aromatic alkyl substitution is not possible. It is explosive reaction. So direct chlorination is not suitable for the preparation of fluorobenzene. Okay, write down there. Direct chlorination of benzene is not suitable for the preparation of fluorobenzene. So here, for the preparation of the fluorobenzene, there is a one indirect method. That is the by using diazonium phosphate. So first of all, do that. Write down this. So now, so direct fluorination is a explosive reaction. So here there is an indirect method for the preparation of the fluorobenzene. So that is nothing but Ball-Schemann reaction. Which one? Ball-Schemann reaction. So in this Ball-Schemann reaction, the benzene diazonium chloride on heating with tetrafluoroboric acid. Okay? This one is the tetrafluoroboric acid. So benzene diazonium chloride on heating with tetrafluoroboric acid, we will get the fluorobenzene. Okay? It is an indirect method. It's not a direct fluorination. So here, what are the steps involved in this reaction? The first step, by heating, it is dissociated to phenyl cation and N2 and Cl minus also. Phenyl cation and N2. Actually, it is an unstable one. This benzene diazonium chloride is unstable. Okay. So here, that means here more than 10 degrees centigrade. Just more than 10 degrees centigrade. By heating this benzene diazonium chloride at more than 10 degrees centigrade, that is dissociated, that is converted to phenyl cation and N2 plus. So here, what is the driving force for this reaction is N2 formation. N2 for N2 is more stable, so that's it. It is readily dissociated. N2 is an excellent leaving group. Okay, we are saying in SN1 and SN2 reactions, N2 is an excellent leaving group. So that's why leaving of N2 is very feasible. So that's why phenyl cation is formed. Actually, it is an unstable carbocation. Even if it is unstable carbocation, its formation is easier because N2 molecule stability. Okay? So phenyl cation form anything. Now, in second step, from the BF4 minus, H plus to BF4 minus, H plus BF4 minus. From this one, F minus attacks on this phenyl cation. So product is fluorobenzene is the product. Okay? Phenyl cation attacked by the F minus. So in this case, it involves two steps. One, first step is the formation of the phenyl cation, and second step is the attacking of the nucleophile. There is nothing but F minus. So in this one, first step is the slow step, and second step is the fast step. First step is the slow step and second one is the fast step. So formation of the cation is a slow step and nucleophile attacking is a
the same phenomenon you can observe in SN1 reaction. SN1 reaction, first formation of the carbocation, next attack of the electrophile. So here also, first formation of the carbocation, next attacking of the attacking of the nucleophile from the HBF4-. So here, it's nothing but nucleophile substitution. But this nucleophile substitution on the aromatic ring, that's why this reaction is called as aromatic nucleophilic substitution reaction. Unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Why is it unimolecular? Because here formation of the carbocation from only benzene diazonate chloride. In this first step, only benzene diazonate chloride is involved. In the second step, HBF4 molecule is also involved. So here rate of the reaction depends on only concentration of the benzene diazonate chloride. So order is one, or molecular is one. That's why aromatic unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. It is called as aromatic unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Very, very important. Benzene diazonate chloride are heated with HBF4, we get the chloroquine. That's it. One more obligation here also, N2 plus Cl minus is heating with the HBF4, we get the fluorothane. Of course, that is the derivative. Now here, how to get this benzene diazonate chloride? How to get this pH N2 plus Cl minus? How to get benzene diazonate chloride? So this benzene diazonate chloride is formed from the aniline action. Of course, you know this nitrobenzene are treating with the TiNaHCl, look at the reduction reaction, or iron HCl. The product is aniline. This aniline on reaction with NaNO2 HCl or HNO2 at 0 to 5 degree centigrade. At 0 to 5 degree centigrade. So here that NH2 group is converted to N2 plus Cl minus benzene diazonium chloride. So how to get the benzene diazonium chloride? First here nitrobenzene on reduction with TiNaHCl or iron HCl with the reduction reaction, that NO2 converted to NH2, and this ending on reaction NaNO2 HCl or HNO2 at 0 to 5 degree centigrade, we have to maintain the low temperature because that benzene diazonate chloride is unstable. Okay. Now in this case, first here, NaNO2 plus HCl that produce HNO2. Okay, that produce HNO2. Okay. Now this HNO2 or further reaction with the HCl, protonation of this OH takes place and this NO. So here loss of water molecule, we will get the NO plus and water. Okay, first here NaNO2 HCl, HNO2, that is HNO2 on treating with HCl. That means excess of HCl is used in this reaction. So protonation of this OH. So loss of water molecule will get the NO plus nitrosyl. This is NO plus. So now here that NO plus acting as a electrophile. NO plus acting as a electrophile and this NH2. That means on this nitrogen, lone pair of electrons are there, acting as a nucleophile. So then we will get the pH N hydrogen, hydrogen bond, carbon bond. So now we have loss of water molecule. So we get the pH N2 plus and H2. This is a benzene diazonium ion. Okay? Of course, your method is not necessary. Just remember the sequence of this reaction. Aniline on reaction with the NaNO2 HCl or HNO. Why you are using NaNO2 HCl? Because HNO2 is unstable, it is readily converted to HNO3. So that's why at the time of reaction, we are using NaNO2 and HCl. Okay, it is a ball Schwann reaction. So remember this one. It is a AlSNR reaction. Aromatic unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. And now one more application. Now suppose benzene on nitration. HNO2H2SO4 is a nitration reaction. You will get the nitrobenzene. And this nitrobenzene are treating with FeHCl reduction reaction. That NO2 converted to. We will get the one more step. First, suppose this one Br2AlCl3 bromination. NO2 is a meta directing. Anode is meta directive, so bromine Br plus is L profile and it acts at the meta position. And now iron HCl reduction reaction, so that is converted NH2 and bromine. Now here and next step is first suppose. First one is the HNO2, 0 to 5 degrees centigrade, and the second one HBF4E. In the first step, that means I am reacting with HNO2, that I have H2 converted to N2 plus Cl minus. Now I am meeting with HBF4, that is replaced by the fluorine. So finally, product is fluorobromo. Bromo fluoro benzene the product. That is one sequence. Okay, there was some sequence of reactions. Nitration first of all, next bromination. NO2 is the meta directive. So Br plus L propyl attacks at the meta position and then reduction and then this process is nothing but diazotization. This is diazotization. Conversion of aniline into diazonium chloride. Conversion of aniline into benzene diazonium chloride is known as diazotization. So in this case, diazotization. In the diazotization, it is converted to N2 plus Cl minus on a heating with HBr4. It is nothing but Ball Schwann reaction. So finally, product is meta bromo fluoro benzene. Okay, that is about the Ball Schwann reaction. By the Ball Schwann reaction, we can prepare the aryl chlorides. So, one more example for the AlSNO1 reaction. So, aromatic unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. One more example. First of all, this benzene diazonium chloride. This benzene diazonium chloride are heating with water at more than 10 degrees centigrade. It is replaced by the OH plus HCl plus N2. Okay? So in this case, first on heating, it gives a phenyl cation plus N2 plus Cl minus. Now it is attacked by water nucleophile. So here H plus and then Cl minus remove the proton. Cl minus remove the proton, phenyl is the product. So in this reaction also, first, this benzene diazonium chloride on heating, that is a phenyl cation. Now, it is attacked by the water molecule acting as nucleophile. So, it is a protonated compound. And by the giving of H+, that means here, this H+ is removed by the Cl-. In the first step, it is formed. So, HCl, loss of HCl, and then finally we get the phenol. So, in this case here,
The phenyl carried the reaction intermediate. This reaction also ARSMO, aromatic unimolecular nucleotide substitution reaction. Okay, this is another example for the ARSMO. Sequence of reactions. Calcium carbonate, H2O, red hot iron 2, HNO3, HSO4, Cl2, HCl3, H2 platinum, NaNO2, HCl, 0 to 5 degrees centigrade. It means hydrolyzation and then H2O. Okay? So, red hot iron. Now, here, this benzene diazonyl chloride on treating with potassium iodide. This benzene diazonyl chloride on heating with potassium iodide, we will get the iodobenzene. Okay, it is one reaction. Benzene diazonyl chloride on heating with potassium iodide gives iodobenzene. Now, Sandway reaction. Okay, very very important reaction. Sandway reaction and next to Gattner reaction. These reactions are very very important for object 2 as well as API combination, Fittig reaction, which Fittig reaction. And this one, Hansdaker reaction, Sachs reaction, Finkelstein reaction, Sandway reaction, Letterman reaction, Ball-Schumann reaction, all these are the very very important reactions from this chapter for IP as well as objective examination. So in this Sandway reaction, it is also preparation of the aryl halides from benzene diazonyl chloride. So actually here, this benzene diazonyl chloride on treating with CuClHCl, chlorobenzene, CuBrHBr, bromobenzene, CuCmHCl, cyanobenzene. Okay? So that diazonyl chloride group is replaced by the Cl, bromine and the Cl. So actually, Ball-Schumann reaction involves a phenyl cation. Ball-Schumann reaction involves phenyl cation. But in this case, this reaction, Sandway reaction or Gattner reaction, both reactions involve radicals. So, phenyl radical is the reaction generated. So, phenyl radical is nothing but like this. Phenyl radical is involved in this reaction. It's a very, very important point. Ball-Schumann reaction involves phenyl cation and hydrolysis reaction also involves phenyl cation. But in this case, Sandway reaction, Gattner reactions, involves phenyl radical. Okay? Sandway reaction and Gattner reaction. Products are same, reactant same, but slightly the nature of the reagent is different. Here in this case copper, here in this case CuCl. Okay? CuHCl, CuHBr, CuHCl. But in this case CuCnHCl, CuBrHBr, CuCnHCl. Okay? Sandway reaction and Gattner reaction. Very important this one. Just in the replacement reaction. So, those are the preparation of the aryl halides. Okay. So, another one method for the preparation of chlorobenzene, this one. This is a benzene HCl O2 in the presence of copper, we get the chlorobenzene. So, hydrogen, ribosome, here oxygen, H2 is the cycle. Benzene HCl O2, copper, chlorobenzene is the product. Okay, next physical properties of alkyl halides as well as aryl halides we will discuss. So, physical properties are first boiling point. Boiling point increases with increasing molecular weight. Alkyl chloride, alkyl chloride, alkyl bromide, alkyl iodide. Molecular weight increases, boiling point increases. CH3Cl, CH2HCl, C3H7, Cl. Molecular weight increases of the side chain alkyl group, so then boiling point increases. So in this case CH3Cl, CH2Cl2, CHCl2, CCl2. Molecular weight increases with increasing number of chlorine atoms. Next, for isomeric halides, it is a 5 carbons, that means N pentyl chloride, it is a secondary pentyl chloride, it is a tertiary pentyl chloride. With increasing branching, boiling point decreases. And next, for aryl halides, so ortho, para, meta. Okay, this is boiling point values also given in test book. So, ortho has higher boiling point, next para and then meta. And next, coming to the melting point, para, argo, and meta. Okay, the slightly the difference. Boiling point, argo has higher boiling point. Next, melting point, para has a higher melting point. But in both cases, meta is summarized least melting point as well as least boiling point. And next, density. Density increases with increasing molecular weight. So CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3CH3
increases. Okay, with increasing molecular weight, density increases.
Okay, next another physical property, there is a dipole moment.
Dipole moment is the product of charge and distance. So now here, methyl fluoride, methyl chloride, methyl bromide, methyl iodide. So in this reaction, so higher the polarity, higher the dipole moment. For suppose, H here, H here, HBr, H. Which are the higher polarity? HF has a higher polarity. So HF has a higher dipole moment than the HCl and then the HBr and HF. But in this case, of course carbon fluorine has a higher polar bond than the carbon fluorine bond, because carbon fluorine has a more electronegativity difference. Here 2.25, here 4.0, here 2.5, here 3.0, chlorine 3.0. So less electronegative difference is a more electronegative difference, it is a more polar bond. But in this case 2p carbon and 2p fluorine, in this case 2p carbon and 3p carbon. So in this case here the carbon fluorine bond length is higher, that means here the value B is more for CH3Cl than the CH3F. Of course the polarity equally, so this one must have a higher dipole moment than the CH3Cl. But dipole moment is the product of the charge and distance. So you charge in plus the distance in multiply this CH3Cl equals to dipole moment. So finally, yes, CH3Cl has higher dipole moment than the CH3, and then CH3Br, and then CH3I. Okay? It is the product of the charge and distance. So our two values in which is much checking value. Okay? Only polarity consider this for the only distance we consider. Distance consider this d equals the actual 2p and 5p. So d value charge equals, but polarity 0, actually 2.5 and iodine also 2.5. So my electronic difference 0. So charge and develop. So charge my equity book that 0. So it's two values in consider this for charge and distance. So two values in cancel just CH3Cl equal. So very important with this. Okay? But HFCl is called HF equal, dipole moment. Next if a dihalide is called the same CH2F2 equal. Is a different? Okay, dihalide CH2F2, CH2Cl2, CH2Br2, CH2I2. Now aromatic dihalides question was there. So general dipole moment is inversely proportional to theta. So chlorine is with the time group. So in a bond moment direction towards chlorine. A bond moment direction towards chlorine. So angle theta 60. Now in this case, bond moment towards chlorine. In this case, bond moment is towards chlorine. So theta 120. Here theta. Here theta is 180 degrees. So in this case, exactly opposite. This carbon chlorine bond is exactly opposite. The polarity of this carbon pole and this carbon pole is same, polarity is same, charge is same, but direction different, because dipole moment is a vector control, it has specific direction and specific magnitude. So opposite direction over T, so polarity of two bonds cancel each other, so dipole moment 0. And this one, the symmetrical trichlorobenzene is also dipole moment 0. Okay, symmetrical 1,3,5 trichlorobenzene dipole moment 0. Now what suppose, so here in this case, so ortho, meta, para, ortho has a higher dipole moment, next meta and para 0 dipole moment. Now next one, chlorobenzene dipole moment 1.53 dB, then 1, 2, 3, 5 tetrachlorobenzene dipole moment is also 1.53
pi 3 divided. And we can actually by removing this one. So the polarity, the bond moments due to all these three carbon property, then the dipole moment cancels out totally. But additionally, they involve something polarity just for due to one carbon chlorine single bond. So carbon chlorine bond number compound which have polarity 1.53 divided. So that's why it has the same value 1.53 divided. And of course, there is a tetrachloride. They are exactly opposite. So exactly opposite. So its dipole value 0. And another important point is cyclohexane and chlorobenzene. Which one has a higher dipole moment? So if cyclohexane has a higher dipole moment, why? Endukani here due to lone pair pi conjugation. Due to lone pair pi conjugation. Negative, positive, pi bond and pi. Due to lone pair pi conjugation, this bond length decreases. But in this case, no conjugation. So higher the bond length. With increasing the D value, polarity is same of course. Carbon chlorine, the carbon chlorine. But in this case, only single bond. But if this single bond converted to double bond, so bond length D and A will decrease. So but in this case, D is a higher. So this cyclohexane has a higher dipole moment. So here in this case, D value decreases. So dipole moment value decreases. So very important this one. Okay, so that is about the early habits, preparation methods and physical properties. So in next class, we will discuss about the chemical properties of all type habits.